Reluctance motors are used in signaling devices, control devices, automatic regulators, recording devices, clocks, teleprinters, gramophones, analog electric meters, electric vehicles, and power tools like drill lathes, bandsaws, and presses. What are reluctance motors? Though invented in the early 19th century, reluctance motors have only recently gained traction thanks to microelectronics and advanced control systems. A reluctance motor is an advanced type of motor that uses both stators and rotors, just like most electrical motors. The reluctance motor has the following characteristics. The rotor has no permanent magnets, no windings, and no short circuit cage. For this reason, the cost of manufacturing reluctance motors is very low. Because of the missing excitation in the rotor, the power density of reluctance motor is lower than in permanent magnet synchronous motors. Note that reluctance motors do not have a cogging torque and have a higher safety in case of a short circuit. Since the reluctance rotor has no windings or permanent magnets, the reluctance motor can be cooled well and is very resilient against high temperatures. The operation of reluctance motors is relatively simple. In order for the rotor to rotate, the magnetic resistance must change with the position. The magnetic resistance is also called reluctance, which is where the name reluctance motor comes from. When a voltage is applied to a winding in the stator, a current flows. The current generates a magnetic flux that flows through the stator and the rotor. The rotor turns in the direction in which the magnetic resistance for the magnetic flux becomes smaller. This creates torque, which returns to zero when the rotor reaches the position of lowest magnetic resistance. To obtain a continuous rotary motion, a voltage must then be applied to the next winding. Types of reluctance motor. There are two types of reluctance motors. 1. Switched reluctance motors, SRM. 2. Synchronous reluctance motors. The difference between switched reluctance motors and synchronous reluctance motors is that switched reluctance motors have concentrated windings, while synchronous reluctance motors have distributed windings. The synchronous reluctance motor has a smaller torque ripple and is therefore quieter in operation. Synchronous reluctance motor has a higher efficiency than switched reluctance motors. This is because the switched reluctance motor requires higher phase currents and the magnetic flux density is lower in synchronous reluctance motors. The structure of the stator of synchronous reluctance motors is nearly identical to that of an induction motor. The rotor consists of a round laminated core from which magnetic flux barriers are stamped. The rotor is not suitable for high speeds, because for high speeds, additional bars must be inserted into the flux barriers to guarantee speed stiffness. However, these webs have a negative effect on the efficiency of the machine. The synchronous reluctance motor has a much smaller torque ripple than a switched reluctance motor. The efficiency is also much higher than that of SRM motors. Because the synchronous reluctance motor has a lower phase current, its inverter or power electronics are less expensive. However, a position sensor with enough resolution must be used to implement good control and regulation. Switched reluctance motor. The stator and the rotor of the switched reluctance motor consist of salient poles. The stator has a concentrated winding, which means that each tooth carries one winding. The number of stator poles and rotor poles must be different. As a rule, the number of poles in the stator is greater than that of the rotor. A typical combination is 6 quarters, that is, 6 stator poles and 4 rotor poles. Since the rotor consists of only one laminated core, the SRM motor is particularly good for very high speeds. The production of the switched reluctance motor is relatively simple, since windings can be pre-wound and only have to be pushed onto the teeth of the stator. The SRM motor has a higher torque ripple, which makes the motor louder than, for example, a synchronous reluctance motor. The torque ripple comes from the higher phase currents that the motor requires. The inverter or power electronics for switched reluctance motors is more expensive than for a synchronous reluctance motor, for example, because of the high phase currents. The resolution of the position sensor, on the other hand, can be low, allowing a less expensive sensor to be used.